The compulsory implementation means that essentially all inbound goods must have local marine cargo insurance to be cleared at all entry points, which inevitably thwarts the responsibility of enforcement and to the country's tax body, Uganda Revenue Authority. This is expected to boost premiums collected by the insurance companies locally.
There's no protectionism. It's just asking people to pay insurance in Uganda, to licensed insurance companies in Uganda. And there's no particular insurance company that has any advantage over another. Yeah, so there's no protectionism. So long as you're licensed to carry out general business in Uganda and you offer marine insurance, you are part of the consortium that is offering this cover to the importers. We are not the first. Other countries do it as well.
The Chief Executive Officer, Uganda Insurers Association, Jonan Chisache, on his part, stressed that annually Uganda has been losing up to $100 million to countries that have been offering insurance covers for cargo destined to Uganda. He added that they will be using the new portal recently launched by IRA to boost the uptake of the cover.
They discovered that East African region was losing about $3 billion as a result of purchasing marine offshore. Uganda specifically was losing about 512 million within this period, and that translated into over $100 million every single year over the period between 2009 to 2013. So I thought I would specify. So what we are trying to do with this initiative is to try and retain these premiums locally.
Meanwhile, the Kasita deputy spokesperson, Dennis Jemba Mlondo, said in the past they struggled with the issue of claims as they were working with foreign companies.
A number of them have been duped by our foreign suppliers. And in the case of a loss, they have only realized that insurance was never paid, and there wasn't any starting point for a claim. This time around, we are saying we have somewhere to run it to in case of a claim for a loss.